श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः। हरि ओम। ओम गणानां त्वा गणपति गुम्भवावहे कविं कवीनां उपमश्रवस्तमं ज्येष्ठराजं ब्रह्मणां ब्रह्मणस्पत आनश्रृण्वन्नोदिभिः सीदसादनम्। ओम श्री महागणपतये नमः। ओम सदाशिवसमारंभां शंकराचार्यमध्यमं अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वंदे गुरुपरंपरां। ओम नमः शिवाय गुरवे सच्चिदानंदमूर्तये निष्प्रपंचाय शांताय निरालंबाय तेजसे। ओम यस्यात्मभूतस्य गुरुप्रसादात् अहं विमुक्तोस्मि संसारबन्धात् सर्वोपदेष्टु शिवानंदमूर्तेः मृद्वग्रयुग्मं प्रणतोस्मि नित्यं दयासिन्धुं दीनबन्धुं शास्त्रार्थबोधनपटुं मत्स्करीन्द्रवरं नौमि श्रीचिदानन्दसद्गुरुं। ॐ प्राणिनां दुःखहर्तारो ज्ञानदो भुवनमुक्तये शिवानन्दचिदानन्दौ आश्रये गुरुसत्तमौ। ॐ शान्तात्मानं प्रणतसुलभं सिद्धविद्याप्रभावं बास्वद्रूपं सुगुणनिलयं द्वस्थकर्मादिवर्गं प्रज्ञावृत्तं निज समदृशं तारदं त्यागिभद्यं साक्षात् ईशं मम गुरुवरं शिवानन्दं नतोऽस्मि शिवानन्दं नतोऽस्मि। ॐ अखण्डानन्दसम्बोधो वन्दनात् यस्य जायते गोविन्दं तमहं वन्दे चिदानन्दतनुं गुरुं चिदानन्दतनुं गुरुं। ॐ टुडे इस विजयदशमी डे, सो ऑन दिस होली डे देन आई थॉट वी हैव डिसकंटिन्यूड बिकॉज ऑफ कोविड देन वी विल स्टार्ट अगेन देन आई थॉट दैट सो मोस्ट ऑफ अस आर सन्यासी and others are in the making, maybe in the sannyasins in the red cloth or sannyasins in the white cloth. So anyway, spiritual seekers. So and according to our parampara, the upadesha, sannyas upadesha, spiritual upadesha, this main spiritual upadesha is tattvamasi. That is upadesha. Tattvamasi is 9 times it is told during sannyas diksha, and aham brahmasmi, finally you say. That is a symbolic ritual. And we are asked to contemplate on the Mahavakyas, the Prajnanam Brahma, Tattvamasi, Aham Brahmasmi, and Ayamatma Brahma. So then I thought, and the Upanishads are there. People study Upanishads. Some of you might have studied Upanishads. Having studied Upanishads, suppose if you ask them, what is the content of Kathopanishads? Kathopanishads, you tell me in short. Sometimes some people have asked me, what is this Upanishad, Kathopanishad? You tell me in brief so that I can understand. So then what happens? Those who study Upanishads, they study, they read Gurudev's book or any other book, and then it will not remain in the mind. Even those who study with Bhashya, it is so complicated that they won't remember what is the content. Kathopanishad, what is Kathopanishad means, what they will say. There was one boy, Nachiketa's father was there, he did not give, and he went to Yama. That's okay. Afterwards, what is the Yama's Upadesha to him? That portion, then we are not able to say this. Okay, that is the case with many people. So I thought we will summarize it. How I got this idea, because some time ago I was teaching this. Then I asked, after finishing Aitareya Upanishad, Prashna Upanishad, what are the 6 questions and what was the answer? What is it? I asked. Then each one has to write something and then bring actually. Then I got that idea. We should be able to summarize the Upanishads. So that is a meditation. What is the Upadesha? Ultimately, what after studying Bhagavad, what is the Upadesha? Janmalapa Parapumsam Ante Narayana Smriti. Okay? Ultimately, I should be able to remember Bhagavan's name in the last moment of life. Okay, I should remember. If you really wish, then what I should do? Then thought will come. Then last moment, I do not know. I am talking now, it can go. So every moment you should remember. Every moment you should remember Bhagavan. So like that, the thought will come. And knowingly or unknowingly, you will be able to do it. So likewise, what is the essence of this Upanishad? What is told there? That way we can think. Little one or two, say one Upanishad, maybe 1.45 minutes or 1.5 hours, within three days. I want to summarize to you. Chandogya and Brihadaranya may not be possible because there are different things are there. Other Upanishads can be summarized actually. So we will try to summarize. You have also studied. Have you any time thoughts like this? What is the Kathopanishad? What is told there? Then suddenly you will feel a blank. Okay? So important mantras we should remember. Otherwise, at least the meaning of that mantra, the content of that mantra, the essence of that mantra we should remember. That is why I am thinking actually. So that is my idea. So we will start with Aitareya Upanishad. Tomorrow I will start with Aitareya Upanishad because the first one, Mahavakya comes, Prajnanam Brahma comes. So I selected that. So today I will give you an outline of what is this Upanishad, where it is, how it is like that. So you all know that our basic scripture is Veda. Veda is the basic scripture and it is always learned by hearing. It was not studied from books. It is learned by hearing. Even today, this knowledge is passed on by hearing only. So it is called Shruti. Shruti heard and learned. By hearing only it is. So it is Shruti. So and you know that the Veda was, before Vyasa Bhagavan, Veda was one big thing. And this Veda was not, who wrote this Vedas? Nobody wrote it actually. So they say in the Brihadaranya Upanishad, it is said, Asya Mahato Bhutasya Nishwasitam Yatati Yat Rigvedo Yajurvedo Samavedo Atharva Angirasaha. So what is this Veda is? There is no mention of any name of God in the Upanishads or Vedas. And Kam Brahma, you know. Kaha means what? Kaha means Brahma. Kaha means Brahma and Brahma, Chaturbhuga Brahma also. Okay? Kaha means what? Who? Koham, Kaha. So Kaha is Brahma. Question, who is that? Who? So Brahma means Chaturmukha Brahma, you should not take Brahma only. Okay. So there is no mention of any God there. That does not mean God is denied, okay? Don't think that God is not there. It does not mention about Rama, Krishna. That is not mentioned there. It is mentioned here is Asya Mahato Bhutasya, that Mahat, that great one. That great one. How we say Bhagavan? Vishwasmai Namaha. Bhagavan means what? All Aishwarya Sampurnaha. That is meaning. So afterwards we give a name Rama. Rama means what actually? Rama means that which Ananda. Shiva means Mangala, all abstract only. Because for our convenience, we have a form and other things, so that we can be able to receive it. Otherwise, we cannot receive. So this is okay, and that is also we should accept. So that they say that in the Vedas came from apaurusheya. Paurusheya means it is not made by any person. Purusha does not mean man. Purusha includes Purusha and Stri according to Pureyati, Purnatvadi, Purishayanadi. So Purusha does not mean masculine. Man you should not take. Purusha Shabda can imply man, woman, everything. Purusha Sukta is like that only. So in the Narayana Sukta, sometimes Visarga will be there, sometimes without Visarga will be there. So one will be in Napumsaka Linga, and the other, I don't just now remember that mantra ending. If you chant, we will know. So it can be Napumsaka, it can be Pullinga. So you can make it Narayanan, Narayanaha. It can also mean it. We use it as use. Ramana Bhagavan also, when they speak, they will say that. It came. It only, they will use only the it. They will not use the word Bhagavan Shvalith. Tamil they say, Shvalith means it told. They don't say Bhagavan in the masculine gender. They will refer Bhagavan as neutral gender. Always they say, because Bhagavan is also beyond the genders. So asya mahato bhutasya, so that great being, it's a nishwasidam vedaha, it's breath. Bhagavan's breath is Veda. What is breath? Our breath is our voice. Your breath is your voice. Your breath is your voice. You understand actually? The prana only comes in the form of sound. Apranan, anapanan, vagvatati. Prana only comes in the form of, it is like a flute. Some other piped instrument is there. Likewise, our prana only. Likewise, that mahatobhutasya nishwasitam vedaha. That is Yajurveda, Rigveda, Yajurveda. So all these things are one tree. One tree, Rigveda, Yajurveda, all together one tree. This side, that side, like that. So Vyasa Bhagavan later on thought that it is very too big. So I will divide it into four. He decided to divide it into four, that Rigveda, Yajurveda, Samaveda and Atharvaveda. Before that it was one tree. Even now it is tree only. That is why every day you are chanting here, Urdhvam Ulamatha Shakam Ashwattam Prahuravyayam. That Ashwatta, that is also like a tree actually. So sometimes people used to say here that the Veda contained 1 lakh slokas, 80,000 slokas are karma and 16,000, that is, I do not know from where they got. Ananta vai Vedaha, Veda, there is no end. How much was there, nobody knows. And there is an interesting story about this Vedas. And Rigveda, Yajurveda, Samaveda, Atharvaveda, in that, each one has got number of branches. So in the Bhagavad also it comes, Bhagavan, Vyasa Bhagavan having divided this into Vedas, four Vedas. Then he taught each one to one disciple. What means one Veda means one big branch. In that branch there are Upashakas will be there. It is like a tree, four branches going. So one branch will have Upashaka will be there. Upashaka, you understand? So there is one Upanishad, I think it is Japala Upanishad or something. In that, how many shakas were there? It is mentioned. Mukti Gopanishad. In that, there is one statement that it is 1130, something like that. 1130,000 belongs to Samaveda. Tasmin Sahasra Shake, then what? Tasmin Sahasra Shake, Nibaga, Hamtoi Braje Swaha. Don't you know? Sahasra Shaka means this. Samaveda is Sahasraka. Afterwards, Rigveda about 21 shakas were there. And Yajurveda about 100 shakas were there, 100 or 101. And about 50 were there in the Atharvaveda. So it all shakas only. Shaka means one tree, Veda is one tree. In that one tree, so many mantras were there. This 1 lakh meaning, this is a wrong statement, somebody without knowing they say. And there is an interesting story in the Yoga Vasishtha or somewhere. Bharadwaja Maharshi wanted to study Vedas complete. I want to study complete. So he started studying. So 100 years, full time he was studying. So, and he could not complete. Then he requested Indra. I could not study, complete it. So you give me another Janma. Okay. So another Janma was granted. So in that another 100 years he studied again. Then again he could not complete. Then he again requested Indra, give me another Janma, 100 years. Okay. So that was also granted. So then he studied in that 100 that year, full third Janma also. Then again could not complete. Then he asked, I want one more Janma. Then he asked, why? He asked, I'm studying Vedas, I want to complete all the shakas. Then he told, do you know it is impossible? I tell you. Then he showed, you see, what is this? He asked. Then three hills were there. So the Vedas are like these. And he took one handful. This much only you have studied. In this three births, we have only studied this much. It is not possible to study all the shakas. Anantavai Vedaha, Ananta. So this, how much is not there? We have got a book here. In that book, one shaka only is there, one shaka little mantras. Even Taittiriya, this Krishna Yajurveda is not there in this. I checked one day. What are there, I checked. So, the mantras are not 1 lakh, and that is a wrong calculation, because in each Veda, how many mantras are there is indexed already those days. Not only it is how many mantras are there, how many padas are there, it is there. How many pada? Suppose if you chant a mantra, then you will know how many padas are there. So even number of letters are also definite. Even we have books. Even in our own library it is a book. In the Rig Veda, how many mantras are there? 10,552. How many padas? I do not know how many is there. How many letters are there? One shaka. So Anantavai Vedaha, Veda is big one. How much we do not know. So in the about 1130, somebody says it is 1180. So many shakas were there. But now, only very few we have. In the Rig Veda, there is only one shaka. That is called Shakali Shaka. That is what today we read, actually. That book is also like that. What is that first mantra? Agnimile Purokitam Yajnasya Deva Mrityujam Hotaram Ratnadatamam. That is Shakali Shaka. Then there is only one shaka is there. In the Krishna Yajurveda, there are two shakas, Kata Shaka and the Taittiriya Shaka. And the Shukla Yajurveda, there are two shakas, Madhyandini Shaka and Kanva Shaka. This commentary is for the Brihadaranya and Ishavasya is based on Kanva Shaka, not Madhyandini Shaka. Shankara Bhagavan's commentary is like that. And in the Samaveda, there are three shakas. One is Kautama Shaka, and the other is Ranayini Shaka, and the third is Jaimini Shaka. This Keno Upanishad is from the Talavakara Shaka, is from the Ranayini Shaka. And in the Atharva Veda, Savanika Atharva Veda, Atharva Veda of the Madhyandini Shaka, no, Atharva Veda, there is Savanika Shaka and Pippalada Shaka, two Shakas are there. So, this Shukla Yajurveda only, this Madhyandini and Kanva. This is Savanika Shaka and Pippalada Shaka. So about 10-15 Shakas only available. Others are all gone actually. All these things are available now. So this, originally in the Yajurveda, there was only Krishna Yajurveda was there. Later on, this Yajnavalkya, there is a story about it. Yajnavalkya directly studied from Aditya and got this knowledge. So from Aditya directly he got it, this Shukla Yajurveda Shakas. So total this many Shakas are there. So out of this, the 10 Shakas are now available. So now the Mahavakyas and the end of the Upanishads, end of the Vedas, they call it as Vedanta or Upanishad. It need not be totally end, sometimes some of these comes in the middle also. The Saitareya Upanishad comes in the middle of the Brahmana. Others normally comes in the end. So Vedanta means Vedas, the Anta of Veda. Anta means two meanings you can take, end. Other means the Charamasloka, they say. Charamasloka means what? the essence of that is told. In the beginning, they will say, I am going to talk on this. Again, they have to conclude, it is so. So, Sarvadharman Parityajya Mamekam Sharanam Raja Aham Tva Sarva Papibhyo Mokshayishyami Maha Shuchaha. That is the essence of the Gita. Ashochyan Anvashochattvam Prajnavadam Chabhashase Gatasun Akatasun Chinani Shochanti Panditaha. That is the beginning. Upakrama Upasamhariyo Huvaikyam, the theory they bring. So, in the beginning, he says, unnecessarily you are worrying. Ashochyan Anvashochattvam, why unnecessarily you are worrying? There is nothing to worry. Then he concludes, Sarvadharman Parityajya Mamekam Sharanam Raja Aham Tva Sarva Papibhyo Mokshayishyami Maha Shuchaha. Don't worry. Don't worry. So that message was what? You are unnecessarily worrying. Well, they are doing the same thing. For no, nothing we are worrying. What you are worried? Worried. What are you are worried? You are Ananda Swarupa. So the essence. So Vedanta means what the Veda says, the essence of the teaching. That also can be meaning. So, and the word Upanishad. Upanishad, two meanings normally say. Now, in simple meaning they say Upasamipe. Upasamipe. Nishada means sit. So to sit near the teacher and learn. To sit near the guru and to learn from him. That is the normal meaning. But Shankaracharya gives a different meaning. Sadirdatoho. Gati Visharana Avasadhana Arthaha. Gati Visharana Avasadhana. Sat is the dhatu, sat is dhatu. Sat dhatu, upa plus ni plus. Then there's a grammar, quip pratyaya, upa, upani purvaka quip pratyaya, it will be there. Don't go into all details. Sat is the dhatu, sat dhatu. Sat dhatu has got gati. What you want to achieve, it helps you to achieve that. Prapaniyam. Gati means yat. Prabhaniyam, yet that what you want to achieve, it promises that. And what is the problem? It removes that. Visharana avasadhana, it removes the ignorance, ajnana, it removes the ajnana and makes you to achieve that ultimate goal of life, Vishwara Prapti. Okay. So that is the meaning. So each Veda has got Upanishads. Every Veda, sometimes more than one Upanishad also. But now about 120 Upanishads are famous Upanishads. 200 are also there, but 120 and 108 Upanishads are famous and books are also available. 120 Upanishad book is there. I also have it. You also have it, I think, some of you. So out of that, Shankaracharya thought we will write commentary on 10 Upanishads because the Veda is very big and it speaks about so many things. So what is the ultimate goal? What is told there? Each one will pick up something and then this is the goal, this is the essence of it, they will say. No, that is not the essence. In order to prove what is the essence, they made a commentary. What is the ultimate goal of Veda? Veda to make you understand that you are Ananda Swarupa. Your nature is Ananda. You are eternal. You are the chip of the same block. If Bhagavan has created you, he has created you in his own form. You are his image. So your nature is Ananda. Your nature is consciousness. Don't think that you are ajnani. I am a papi. Such things are not there. You are Atma Swarupa, radiant immortal Atman, immortal Swarupa. So that is the core teaching. So every word has to be interpreted like that. So somehow people started interpreting different ways. Then he thought, all right, I will write a commentary on this, he said. That's how he started. So, after the Vedas, the rishis also, after having studied, when they have shared the knowledge with their disciples, different type of disciples are there. for somebody they have to give them the some other methods, some other sadhana process, and put it in a simple way also, and help them to remember those things. So the Shruti is the basic grantha, Veda is the Shruti, and then the content of the Shruti they codified and brought out in a small form. The rishis, the content of the Upanishads, they summarized and taught to the students, taught to their disciples, and you practice this, they said. Those books are called Smritis. That is why Bhagavan Vedavyasa, having divided the Vedas into four and taught to his shishyas, Paila he taught Rigveda, the Vaishampayana he taught the Yajurveda, Jaimini he taught the Samaveda, and Atharvangiras he taught the Atharvaveda. Then afterwards he thought this is not enough, so he wrote all the Puranas. So similarly, the other rishis, so the Puranas also contain this essence of the Veda only, it contains. Vedarthe shloke shloke pade pade. I will try to bring out, whenever we have something in the Upanishad, corresponding Bhagavat sloka I will try to bring, because you will be familiar with those ideas, corresponding ideas. Something is there, if it comes to my mind, corresponding, this is the mantra, Veda mantra, this is the meaning, Upanishad mantra. This is how it is told in the Bhagavad. So later on, they wrote their books. They are called Smriti. Smriti means what? Memory. These things you have to remember. Okay, you now you are walking on the road. When you walk, when you cross, you should see both sides, whether anybody, any vehicle is coming. That should be in your memory. A child will not know, it will run. So you have to see. And also, whatever you do, that you have a plan, you know, that all in your memory only. Likewise, I should reach my goal of life. What are things I should do? Those works are called Smriti. So these two are the authorities, the Shruti and the Smriti. Shruti is Upanishads. So the Upanishads and the Bhagavad Gita, Prasthanatri Upanishads, 10 Upanishads, and the Smriti. Brahma Sutra is not an authority. Veda, I'm not denying you, don't think anything wrong. Vedas are apurusheya. It is directly from the Bhagavan. Bhagavad Gita is also directly from the Bhagavan, although it comes through the... So Purusha Sutra, the Brahma Sutra is Vyasa's Kriti, we know. But Vyasa wrote it to... Why it is important, it is one of the Prasthanatri, because Vyasa Bhagavan wrote this to clarify the doubts in these things. You should not interpret it this way, you should not interpret, this is, meaning is this. So this is according to the Veda, it is correct, and this is according to the Smriti, is correct. So what is told in this Shruti and Smriti, that he confirms in this Brahma Sutras. Understand, Brahma Sutra is not a new work. Veda is an authoritative book. Gita is, he has brought it the same thing. What is told in the Vedas, what is told in the Upanishads, he has brought it here. That is why Bhagavad Gita su Upanishadsu Brahma Vidyaya. So Bhagavad Gita is like Upanishads. So this Upanishad is an authority. Gita, because it is retold by Bhagavan, it's also an authority. And what is the function of Brahma Sutra? Brahma Sutra does not say anything on its own. This says the meaning of this is this. Janmadhyasyataha. Janmadhyasyataha why? Tattu samanvaya shastra yonitvati. According to shastra, janmadhyasyataha. Yatova imani bhuta nijayante ye najata nijivanti. So that is why janmadhyasyataha. So Brahma Sutra only confirms this. It is not an independent word. You got my point actually. Prasthanatri, three authoritative granthas are not there. Two authoritative granthas, this Shruti and the Smriti, and Brahma Sutra confirms what it contains. This is so and so I say. So this is so and so I say. I am only confirming that. So Brahma Sutra confirms. Okay. You got it, my point actually. So the Brahma Sutra confirms that. So these are these. So now the 10 Upanishads, you know, Isha, Isha Kena, Katha, പ്രശ്ന മുണ്ടക മാണ്ഡൂക്യ ഐതരേയ ചാന്തോക്യ വൺ മിസ്സിങ് ഐതരേയ ചാന്തോക്യ ടെൻ ഉപനിഷത്ത് ഇൻ ദ ടെൻ ഉപനിഷത്ത് ഓൺലി ദീസ് ഫോർ മഹാവാക്യാസ് കംസ് സോ ദി ഐതരേയ ഉപനിഷത്ത് ഈസ് ഫ്രം ദി ഋഗ്വേദ ആൻഡ് തൈത്തിരി ആൻഡ് കഠോ ഉപനിഷത്ത് ഫ്രം ദി കൃഷ്ണ യജുർവേദ ആൻഡ് ഈശാവാസ്യ ആൻഡ് ബൃഹദാരണ്യക ഫ്രം ദി ശുക്ല യജുർവേദ ആൻഡ് ചാന്തോക്യ ഈസ് ഫ്രം ദി സാമവേദ ബൃഹദാരണ്യക ഈസ് ആൾറെഡി ടോൾഡ് ബൃഹദാരണ്യക ഈസ് ഫ്രം ദി ശുക്ല യജുർവേദ ആൻഡ് മുണ്ടക മാണ്ഡുക്യ ദെൻ പ്രശ്ന ദീസ് ത്രീ ആർ ഫ്രം ദി അഥർവവേദ സോ ഈശാ ശുക്ല യജുർവേദ കേന സാമവേദ ആൻഡ് കഠ യജുർവേദ തൈത്തിരിയ പ്രശ്ന അഥർവവേദ മുണ്ടക ആൻഡ് മാണ്ഡുക്യ അഥർവവേദ ആൻഡ് തൈത്തിരിയ യജുർവേദ അഗെയിൻ ആൻഡ് ചാന്തോക്യ സാമവേദ ആൻഡ് ബൃഹദാരണ്യക ഈസ് ദി ശുക്ല യജുർവേദ സോ ഫ്രം ദി ഐതരേയ ഉപനിഷത്ത് വൺ മഹാവാക്യ ദറ്റ് ഈസ് പ്രജ്ഞാനം ബ്രഹ്മ ആൻഡ് ദിസ് തത്വമസി ഈസ് ഫ്രം ദി സാമവേദ സാമവേദ ദറ്റ് ഈസ് ഛാന്തോക്യ ഉപനിഷത്ത് അഹം ബ്രഹ്മാസ്മി ഈസ് ഫ്രം ദി ബൃഹദാരണ്യ ഉപനിഷത്ത് അയമാത്മാ ബ്രഹ്മ ഈസ് ഫ്രം ദി അഥർവവേദ മാണ്ഡുക്യ ഉപനിഷത്ത് ദീസ് ഫോർ വാക്യാസ് ആർ ദെയർ സോ ഫോർ വാക്യാസ് സോ പ്രജ്ഞാനം ബ്രഹ്മ വിൽ കം ഇൻ ദി ഐതരേയ ഉപനിഷത്ത് ദാറ്റ്സ് വൈ ഹാവ് സെലക്റ്റഡ് ഫസ്റ്റ് സോ ദി പുരാണാസ് ലേറ്റർ പുരാണാസ് ആൾ ദി പുരാണാസ് വിച്ച് അവർ എയ്റ്റീൻ പുരാണസ് റൂട്ട് ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് ദി കണ്ടൻറ്റ് ഓഫ് ദി വേദാസ് ഷി ഹാസ് ബ്രോട്ട് ഇറ്റ് സോ ഇറ്റ് ഇറ്റ് ഇസ് കാൾ വേദാർത്ഥേ ശ്ലോകേ ശ്ലോകേ പദേ പദേ ഷി സേസ് സോ ദി കണ്ടൻറ്റ് ഓഫ് ദീസ് ബിക്കോസ് ദി ഉപനിഷത്സ് ആർ വെരി ടഫ് സോ ഹി ഹാസ് ബ്രോട്ട് ഇറ്റ് ഇൻ ടു സ്റ്റോറി ഫാം ആക്ച്വലി ആൻഡ് ദി വേദ കണ്ടെയ്ൻസ് ത്രീ തിങ്സ് ആക്ച്വലി ഇറ്റ് കണ്ടെയ്ൻസ് സാധന ദറ്റ് ഈസ് കർമ്മ ഉപാസന ആൻഡ് ജ്ഞാന ദാറ്റ് ഈസ് വൈ വൺ ഓഫ് ദ റീസൺ ഫോർ ത്രീ ഒരു വൺ റീസൺ ഫോർ ത്രീ ഈസ് ഋഗ് യജുസ് സാമ അഥർവേദ ഈസ് നോട്ട് ഇൻക്ലൂഡഡ് ദാറ്റ് ഈസ് ഓക്കെ ദി അതർ ഈസ് ദിസ് കർമ്മ ഉപാസന ജ്ഞാന ദീസ് ത്രീ തിങ്സ് ആർ മെൻഷൻഡ് ഹിയർ ദാറ്റ് വൈ ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് കാൾഡ് അതർ ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് കാൾഡ് ത്രീ ഓൾസോ സോ ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് കർമ്മ ഉപാസന ജ്ഞാന ആൾ ദീസ് ത്രീ ആർ ദർ ആൻഡ് ഉപനിഷത്ത് മോസ്റ്റ് ഓഫ് ദി ഉപനിഷത്ത് ഓൾസോ കണ്ടെയ്ൻ ദീസ് ഫോർ എക്സാമ്പിൾ ദിസ് ചാന്തോക്യ ഉപനിഷത്ത് സംതിങ് വിൽ ബി ലൈറ്റ് അബ്സ്ട്രാക്ട് ഞാൻ അദ്വൈത വിൽ ബി ദർ അതർ കേസസ് ഉപാസന വിൽ ബി ദർ ആൻഡ് വി ആൾ ആൾ ഓഫ് എസ് വി കനോട്ട് കൺഫൈൻ ടു കർമ്മ അലോൺ വി കനോട്ട് കൺഫൈൻ ടു ഉപാസന അലോൺ വി കനോട്ട് കൺഫൈൻ ടു ജ്ഞാന അലോൺ ആൾ ദി ത്രീ വിൽ ബി ദർ വാട്ട് എവർ കർമ്മ വി ഡു ലിറ്റിൽ എമൗണ്ട് ഓഫ് ഉപാസന വിൽ ബി ദർ വാട്ട് എവർ യു ഡു ഈവൻ ഇഫ് ആർ ഈറ്റിംഗ് വാട്ട് ഈസ് ദീസ് and you enjoy that enjoyment is upasana only you don't like it so tourist so without the involvement of the mind and emotions kevala karma is not possible suppose if you are going to the temple is a karma doing prostration is a karma and puja kriyas are all karma and the involvement of the mind is also there So that involvement of the mind is upasana. So whatever we do, this karma, upasana and jnana will be there. All these conflicts we should avoid. In Bhagavad there is a very beautiful sloka there. Bhakti paresha anubhutir viraktir anyatra shesha trikayeka kala tushti pushti chutapayo nukasam. Karma, upasana and jnana, bhakti, പരേശ അനുഭൂതി വിരക്തി ഭക്തി വിരക്തി ഭക്തി വൈരാഗ്യ വൈരാഗ്യം ഭക്തി ആൻഡ് ജ്ഞാന വിൽ ഗോ ടുഗദർ ഹി സീസ് ഹൗ യു ആർ ഹംഗ്രി യു ആർ ഈറ്റിംഗ് ആസ് യു പുട്ട് എവറി മോർസൽ ആസ് യു കീപ് ഓൺ ഈറ്റിംഗ് ടു ദാറ്റ് എക്സ്റ്റെൻ്റ് പുഷ്ടി തുഷ്ടി ചുതപായ ടു ദാറ്റ് എക്സ്റ്റെൻ്റ് ആസ് യു ഈറ്റ് വൺ മോർസൽ ടു ദാറ്റ് എക്സ്റ്റെൻ്റ് യുവർ ഹംഗർ ഈസ് ഗോസ് എവേ പുഷ്ടി കംസ് എനർജി കംസ് ആൻഡ് happiness comes. So the happiness, hunger goes, happiness comes, and pushti, energy also comes. All the three simultaneously come with every morsel. Likewise with every karma. Whatever we do, upasana, sadhana. In that karma and upasana and jnana will be there. And accordingly, all the three will be enriched. So this discussion on whether karma is good, bhakti is good, or jnana is good, I don't want jnana, I don't want bhakti, all these things are not correct actually. These are all, these kathagas and other people created actually. Whether Gopi is a greater bhakta and Uddhava is a greater bhakta. Whether let anybody be the greater bhakta, I want to have little bhakti, that should be our attitude. Okay. Who is a great bhakta? What is there? Anyway, I am not a great bhakta, you are not a great bhakta. We will at least go to that level. Now, these are all wrong things actually. So all those things we should avoid. And then, so and everywhere these three things will be told actually. So our mind is always, everybody's mind is disturbed. They have got wants. And each one, nobody thinks alike. What you think and what I think are different. What you think and... So millions of people are there. The thoughts will be millions of thoughts. Nobody thinks alike. But one thing we all think alike. One thought is common to all of us. What is that one thought? I want to be happy. I don't want pain. I want to be happy. That is common to all people. Okay. That thought is common. Okay. Nobody thinks I should have all pains, I should suffer in life. Nobody thinks. I want to be happy. Everybody thinks. So the desire to be happy, the desire to be free from problems, free from worries, that is common to all living beings. Not only you, even the cow, the dog, the cat, the mosquito. The mosquito doesn't like you, do like this. So all people, one thought is common. The mind of all creatures, mind will think one thing. I want to be happy. I don't want pain. I don't want to die. So the how to achieve that is the core teaching of all the Upanishads. So tomorrow with this it is 9 already. So with this we conclude today, and tomorrow we will see the Aitareya Upanishad. Aitareya book, whosoever got Aitareya Upanishad book, good. Principal Upanishad book or small book, or I will bring the mantras and I will tell the simple meaning of the mantras. I will not go into details. Word by word meaning also I will give, but simple meanings. And what is to be remembered, that I will share with you. It is for your sake and for my sake also. I will also think about it. Otherwise, I will be thinking about all problems in life. So, I will also, it is a meditation for me, it is a meditation for all of us. So, on this holy Vijayadashami day, this Gurudev bless all of us to contemplate on the most sacred book, Upanishads, for some time. And I will try to bring out Bhagavad also, so that it will not be very dry, it will be juicy. Okay. Hari Om Tat Sat. Manaso Vrittayo Manasyu Krishna Padam Bhujashrayaha Vachobhirayinir Nam Nam Kayatat Prakhvanadishu Karma Birbramyamananam Yatra Kvapi Ishwarechaya Mangala Jaridir Danihi Ritirna Krishna Ishwari Bhave Bhave Yata Bhakti Padayostava Jayate Tatha Kuru Shvadevesha Nadastum noyada prabhu namasankirtanam yasya sarva papa pranajanam pranamo dukkha shamanam tam namami hari param tam namami hari param om.